In this loft on Hailing Island are the scrapbooks and research notes of Alexander, or Sandy, Mckee. They detail every step on the way to finding Henry VIII's flagship, the Mary Rose.
Well, the most important known wreck in Northwest Europe is here, somewhere here. And I'm going to spend my time on that, and even if I fail, I won't actually have wasted the time, because it was a well worthwhile objective.
Mckee's interest in the ship started as a child.
Well, I think the story goes that when he was a young child on the Isle of Wight, he had found out about the Mary Rose and had sort of imagined himself finding it and bringing it up. So I think maybe that's how it started.
In 1965, he approached the South Sea branch of the British Sub-Aqua Club. For 5 years, they studied the seabed. It was a family affair. Sandy's children would help with logging how long the divers stayed underwater. This rare film was made possible because Mckee wrote to Warner Brothers in America, explained what he was doing, and asked for a camera. As a result, we have unique footage of the first artifacts raised from the Mary Rose.
And then we would go out with the divers, and we would then have some soup for them ready when they came out. The trouble was, at that time, the exit of the sewage was there. And each diver, when they came up, absolutely stank. It was absolutely, everybody ran, you know.
The team was known as Mad Max Marauders. In 1970, they found a Tudor cannon. This proved beyond doubt that the Mary Rose was there. Soon after, archaeologist Margaret Rule joined the project, and the tone of amateur enthusiasm changed.
It became much more official. Instead of that feeling of relaxation and, shall I come with you, Dad? And yeah, that's fine. When I asked, he said, no, you can't, because there's too many people involved and it's all official and, you know, numbers are being counted and everybody's got a job and, you know, there's not a job for you there, whereas there was with the divers.
As the project grew, Mckee's role reduced. And when the Mary Rose was finally raised in 1982, Alexander Mckee was not involved.
Eventually, we were invited to come on to talk more. And he just, poor chap, stood there and was completely ignored. And he had tears in his eyes.
Because without his dream in his head, all those years back on the Isle of Wight, without that dream, the Mary Rose wouldn't be there. The Mary Rose wouldn't be sitting there.
Alexander Mckee was awarded an OBE for his work in rediscovering the Mary Rose. He died in 1992. Aged 72.